Okay, welcome. My name is Sebastian Wodecki. I'm one of the Claudius consultants, and today I would like to show you a few new things we are going to introduce for Claudiax. We have changed our look and feel, and today I would like to show you how you will going to work in the future. Okay, so if you have any questions, you can open your microphone and ask directly, or you can also type it into the chat. I will try to keep an eye on the chat window as well. Okay, so the new Claudiax environment will have. Will have. Where's my PowerPoint? We'll have an HTML5 web access, which will also work as full RDP. So it's not the known SAP Business One web access. So I think we will directly start with it. So when you're going to open a browser, and then you will get an URL from us directly for your customer. So you will get for you all. For each customer, you will get your own URL. Then still we have our Claudiax users here. And then we need still need to enter the password. And then you will get into a new web portal where you have some applications published, what you also already known from the old environment. But here you have, for example, now the floating panel. So now the system will connect to the server. And now you see here, you have on the left side, this is called remote app. And here you have some apps, for example, SAP Business One. So I will start now SAP Business One. Select one of the databases. And you see here the environment is now started into my Firefox browser. But it's not the web the known web browser access from SAP. So it's a full normal Windows screen from SAP. And so for example, if you want to do a sales order, I don't know why it's not starting now. So then I will show you here the desktop folder we have now. So he's going to open a new tab here as well. So now we have here the what we had in the past with the company share. Now we have here also it's called desktop folder in this case. On the desktop we have now some applications. Sorry, documents. In this case, it's an Excel file. Here we have a Word document, and if I do a double click on it, he's connecting your local environment and will open it then locally on your local computer. So he's asking me now to open it on my local computer, and now I have here the document. What was what is in the Claudiax environment? So it's opened locally on your computer. So this is also working with Word documents and also, for example, with Outlook message documents. So when you want to print something, then for example, here we have here a document, you want to print something, you say print, then you have here a universal printer. When we click on print, the system will directly produce a PDF file, what you can then save on your local machine, or you can, for example, directly print it from here. So there's a direct connection between your CloudX environment and your local PC. Are there any questions? Okay. So this local web access is also working on all tablets because it's HTML5. So if you open your, for example, your Safari browser and you will enter this URL or it's the URL of your customer, you can log into it and you will get then this HTML5 ADP window. You have also the possibility in the web view to upload and download data. So you can, for example, open a file transfer here. Then you can click on it, and then, for example, you can say, "I want to upload this Outlook message file," and then you see it directly here on your desktop. And of course, you can open it again. So the link is there again and will communicate directly with Outlook. So the system knows, okay, there's an Outlook on your local PC, and he will open it directly in your local Outlook. Okay, so if there are no questions, I will check if my SAP is working now. What does that look like? Okay, so there will be also no limitation for some add-ons. So if you have a normal, I don't know, cost you B1 up, everything you can install because of the normal SAP application, there will be no limitation for your add-ons. So there will be it will be not necessary to implement all the web browser access features you normally need for SAP. And then, for example, if you want to do a PDF here, then the system is contacting again your local system, and then you can directly save it onto your local desktop, or you also can open it. The same will work if you do a print job. products we also directly get. The PDF file, what you can print out then afterwards. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, then I will continue. The next way to log in for your customer is an app we will provide to you after we have deployed your new environment. So then you will get a small app like this. You can do a double click on it. And first I will log out here. And here you can say connect. Then you will get this small remote app on the left side here, or you can move it around. Now we are connected already to CloudYX. And if you click here on Zappos One, for example, the system will open the RDP connection. Log into it. And then, for example, if I want to print an invoice, or maybe do first a preview, I can click here on PDF. The system is going to connect again the local environment. And will show you directly the preview on your local PC. So you can see here below, these are the remote apps, let's say, and here you have the local. PDFs. If I want to print something, I can select my universal printer again. And in this case, it will behave a little bit different because we have configured the app like this that you can afterwards, you have started the print job, you can define a local printer on your side. So, for example, you want to print every time on the same machine. So you can configure the app in this way that you can always print on the default printer, or we can define it that you will get this pop-up and you can define the printer yourself. And then, the printer will get printed. Any questions? For example, the integration to the to your local desktop is here the same. So we have here our examples again. When you open them. The system is not asking you like you have it in the browser here. He will directly open it. And then you can look into it. It is not possible to do changes here and save them back. So if you want to save them back, then you need to upload this file again to CloudYX. So it's not that you can do a save here, but you always can open it locally. So if there are no questions right now, then I would continue with the new partner server.
Partner server.
So if you have any questions, you also can
Okay.
write into the chat. Ah, there.
Chat. Ah.
There's a question: when a document or
Question.
XLS is
A
attached
document
to a SBO
attached to a
document, will Word or Excel open the
document.
doc without download? No, it will download it and then
And then
open it. What do you mean with shared folder?
with shared.
So you have still the company share where you can or where all employees have access to. So and yes, you also have the possibility to upload and download things from your HTML5 browser. So I can show you. I can go quickly back. 1 second. For example, I go to the desktop. And then you have also the possibility here to say from server to PC. And there you will also see here all. So this is the server right now. So you have access to the environment of the server. And you also have, of course, with this file manager here
Manager here.
to transfer files up and down.
So I can put a folder here.
You can also put a folder here, yes.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. And in this case, at the moment, it's only the desktop of the server, but you also can, of course, do your own structure. You can define your own structure somewhere on the server and then define there are some special folders. So this is just now an example. And to show that you have the possibilities to do such things.
Excuse me, can I put any extension file here?
What kind of file?
Any extension like PPTX,
Yes.
XLX.
So you have here right now, this is Excel Word. You can put here everything.
Okay, thank you again.
And it's then also connected and again to your local so PC. So if you for example PowerPoint, you can also open locally then.
And anyone can see the shared folder here.
Yes, you can define that. If you want to see a shared folder for everyone or only for your own or for a certain group of users, so that's something then what we can define.
From where exactly can I do this?
I will show you on the partner server because here this is actually only for your end customer, the environment.
Okay.
And if there are no questions anymore, then I would go over now to the partner server. And then I would log out here. And here I have a link for the management server. So this server is not limited into this app structure, what I showed you with this remote app. Here you will directly go to the server and log on to the full RDP. On the desktop here, you see we have here, for example, here's a PDF file, what is also linked again. I'm not sure why it's not complaining now. So you have here now a customer folder. In this customer folder, we will place every time you get a new customer, we will place every time a new folder here with the customer number and name. And behind, then you will find the RDP connections to the customer servers. Because your partner server will be for the future the server which where you can connect to all your customer servers. So then, for example, you would hear this is the server where we worked on before. And now we are on the server, on the customer server, because in our example here, this is the TS, so the terminal server, and here this is the management server. And then you will have local admin permissions to work on here. And you have here the company share from the customer. And here, this is the share where your customer can place all his files, and all employees will see them. Here, you will also be able to add additional folders. And then you have also access here to SAP. Of course, you need to have then access to the cloud control center and to assign you to the tenants. But this will be an other training. You have full control about your customer terminal server, and you can do here your consultancy work. Any questions?
Any questions?
Okay, then I will log me out here. And of course, this server will also be available to the outside via the HTML5 access. So you also can open this full RDP screen on your mobile device or in your web browser. Okay, so if there are no questions, then I will log out here. And this app we will provide you for your partner environment, of course, but also then for your customers. And we'll put them every time into the company share folder where you can download them, but we also attach them to the ticket when we deploy a new customer, so that you can directly download them and start them. So it's a small executable. Okay, if there are no questions anymore, I will show you something in my PowerPoint, because we get many times the question how actually the environment is built up, how your customer is working in. And we tried to make a diagram to show you the details. So there we have here the SAP cloud landscape, our cloud control center, where of course is also our license server is connected to. And then the partner has in many times his own service unit. In the service unit, you have your own database server and your own job service, analytics service, mobile service, all these things which belongs to a HANA or to a SAP Business One deployment. Then in your own service, you have your customer terminal servers and your own partner terminal server. And you have a direct LDP connection to your to the customer terminal servers, so you can directly, as I showed you with these shortcuts we have placed on your desktop, you can directly connect to the terminal server, and your customers can use then the external connection via. The CloudX RDP app I showed you. So this apps, or via HTML5. So as you can see here, so it's a service unit is actually your environment where all your hardware or software components, server services are bound together. Are there any questions?
Are there any questions?
So, for example, if you would do need some work, for example, for customer A on the database, then you would log on to your partner management server, then you could open here, for example, the HANA Studio and connect to the database server and do the adjustments. And so there would be not necessary for you to log on to the customer server. For example, if there would be the case that some user is maybe locked or maybe his session crashed or his SAP is hanging, so then you also could be log on to your partner management server, go to the server and log off the user yourself. So with this new architecture, you have the possibility to do a lot of many more things on your own. And that you also can be more flexible. Okay, so if there are no questions anymore, I would like to say thank you. Thank you for your time and have a good day or a good afternoon.